हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रीति तिक्कस, लेक्चरर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ए शिफ्ट ऑफ प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। सो फर्स्ट वन इज, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मटेरियल यूज फॉर द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लाइन्स। सो फर्स्ट मटेरियल यूज फॉर द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लाइन इज लाइन कंडक्टर। So what are the properties of the line conductor? So low resistivity, so the power losses is less and the voltage drop in the line is also less. The temperature coefficients of the resistance must be less so that the resistance changes to the small extent on the increase of the temperature. It should not corrode in the open atmosphere, it should not oxidize, it should be solderable and easy to join. Flexibility as well as the tensile strength is expected. Cost must be moderated. So what are the factors for the selection of the conductor? So first factor is high electrical conductivity, high tensile strain, low density, low cost and the easily available. Then next is types of conductor. In the line conductor, types of conductors. So first conductor is the copper conductor. The copper conductor material comes in the three forms: hard drawn copper, medium hard drawn copper and soft drawn copper. So hard drawn copper are most popular for the transmission work. It is highest tensile strain among the three types. The features of the hard drawn copper materials are: first one is higher conductivity as compared to other material, higher current density, hence the size of the conductor required is less, low specific resistance, then it is durable, long life and high scrap value. So solid conductor has only the conductor of this one section and strain conductor core is made up of so many conductors together to form a bunch. Such conductor have the good flexibility. Then second type of the conductor is all aluminium conductor. It is also called as a ACC. These are mainly used for the low voltage distribution system. It's use a bunch of the aluminium conductor which are strained. Straining increases flexibility. What are the features of the ACC? So better flexibility due to the straining, durable and the light. Conductivity is 66% as that of the copper. Weight is half of the copper conductor. Average ultimate strength is 65% as that of the strained copper. Next is ACSR conductor. One more type is ACSR conductor. So ACSR conductor is have the high tensile strain. ACSR, that means aluminium conductor strain rail force. This the ACSR conductor has less tensile strain. This drawback is overcome by ACSR conductor. The aluminum conductor having the central core of the galvanized steel wire surrounded by the strained aluminium conductor is known as the ACSR aluminium conductor strain rail force. The steel wire increase the tensile strain. The stranded conductor increases ACSR, the flexibility of the conductor. So as comparing the ACC conductor, ACSR is good one. Then next is next types of conductor is cadmium copper conductor. So this is the alloy of the copper and cadmium, that means cadmium inserted 1 to 2%. The tensile strength is 40% more than the copper. Conductivity is 83% that of the copper, and it is used for the river crossing where long span are present. These were also used for the telephonic lines, that means telegraph and telephone lines. Then next is galvanized steel conductor. So steel conductor coated with the zinc from the galvanized steel conductor. In olden days it was used for the 11 kV line in the ruler. So these are the different types of conductors. Next is line support used in the distribution line. So line support requirement, so what are the requirement for it? First one is the mechanical strength. The mechanical strength, it is should be have the good mechanical strength to withstand stress produced due to the weight and the swing of the conductor. Then second one is the weight. It is light in weight with sufficient strength. Erection of the support easy if the light is weight. Then next is simple. It should have the less number of parts, so assembly is simple. Cost, it is affordable, that means it is cheap in cost. Then maintenance should be less. It has a longer life. Appearance is also pleasant, and the withstand adverse climate condition. So these are the different requirements for the line support. Then next is span. Selection of line support by the governed by following points. Span. So span is very very important. So in the span, the nose sag is produced, or it's a very very small sag is produced. If the sag is produced, so it consume the voltage drop. Then cross section area. Next, selection of line support for the over operating voltage of line. And last one is cost and the local condition. Then next is other components and their function. So first is support. Support, that means pole. So to support the distributor conductor, then line conductors to distribute the power, that means by using the ACSR conductor. Then insulator to support conductor on the cross arm of pole. Then lighting arrester to safeguard from lighting. Then cross arm to support the insulators. Then earthing, line is earthed after every kilometers for the safety leakage and lighting. Then guard wire to avoid the accidents and to trip off the lines if the conductor broken and the fall down. देन स्टे असेंबली टू सपोर्ट द पोल अंडर टेंशन. सो दीज आर दी कंपोनेंट्स, इम्पॉर्टेंट कंपोनेंट्स फॉर दी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लाइन्स. थैंक यू.